Shall I start, ma'am, with your kind permission? Good evening, one and all present here. What an honor and privilege to be here amongst the august gathering gracing the occasion. I, Vandana Verma, from Satyam College of Education, take this opportunity to welcome each one of you to the valedictory function of this international conference on reflection on holistic, multidisciplinary, and futuristic aspects in higher education. The conference was divided into two technical sessions. 24 deliberations were there on different topics covering the theme of the conference, and 7 expert speakers were there to confer their wisdom on different topics in the technical sessions of all 3 institutions. The aim of the conference was to reinvent the new strategies to adapt to the transformative period to improve the institutional resilience intensively in higher education. The conference witnessed much coveted discussions on various aspects, challenges, and issues related to education, fashion, and media. In between the pandemic, with an idea to maintain the sustainable practices to cater the need to strike a balance between the upcoming alpha generations and the children living at the margins, the need of convergent journalism and developing cognitive intelligence with the vocational programs for higher employability were the major highlights of the conference. The premier think tank across India who participated deserve appreciation for their valuable inputs pertaining to the theme of the conference. This is a matter of immense pleasure for us, for our institution, as the conference proved to be a synergy of the thoughtful brains. I hope you all have learned a lot. With this, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to the chief guest, participants, and the entire team of Satyam Group of Institutions for making this program a grand success. Now, the much awaited moment has come. I would like to introduce all with the chief guest of the valedictory session, Professor Shashikala Vanjari, former Vice Chancellor, SNDT Women's University, and also a renowned scholar. I invite Ms. Preeti Goyal, HOD SCE, to welcome our chief guest. Ma'am, please come to the dais.
Thank you, Vandana ma'am. Thank you so much. Good evening to all. It's a great honor to have Professor Shashikala Vanjari ma'am with us today. Ma'am, we know you need no introduction, because you are a sculpture of humanity, source of knowledge. Ma'am, you have remarkable contribution in every field, whether it is education, research, or social work. Ma'am is former Vice Chancellor of SNDT Women University, Mumbai. Ma'am has done MSc Biochemistry, MA English, MEd, and SET Education. She has 34 years experience in teaching, 15 PhD awarded under ma'am's guidance. Ma'am has received fellowship award of Commonwealth Council of Educational Administration and Management. It is a outstanding achievement. Ma'am has received the award, Dr. Anand Vaskar Award, Madam Curie Award, Mahila Vizhnan Puruskar by Swadeshi Vidyanan Andolan Karnataka. Ma'am is associated with different academic staff colleges across the world, across the country, as RTM Nagpur, ACS College, Saurashtra University, Rajkot, and ma'am has delivered more than 200 lectures in different higher education institutions. She has published 2 books, and she has visited different countries to discuss different educational countries like Thailand, Singapore, Nepal, Canada, China, Sri Lanka. She has published more than 42 research papers in different journals. She has attended near about 25 international conferences and 50 state and national conferences. Ma'am is associated with different professional bodies like CTE, CCEAM, RCEAM, WCCI. She has contributed in different institutions because she is associated with them and giving them guidance in different ways. She is academic advisor of TDC. So ma'am, now I don't want to be in between and I want you to come and share your word of wisdom with all of us. Thank you ma'am. Welcome ma'am.
Good evening, one and all. Today all of us have gathered here for the valedictory function of the conference, which is on reflection on holistic, multidisciplinary and futuristic aspect in higher education. This international virtual conference is organized by Satyam Group of Institutions, and definitely I would extend heartiest greeting to management and principals of both the units and students as well. Friends, we know that since morning we are hearing the various speakers who they focus their long experience in the domain of higher education on the theme, and you got to know that what is the need of this particular topic, such as reflection on holistic, multidisciplinary and futuristic aspects. When we speak about reflections on holistic approach, it means we are lagging behind the world, and as we have document received regarding National Education Policy 2020, and in that document it is reflected as the National Education Policy 2020 is the first education policy of the 21st century and aims to address the many growing developmental imperatives of our country. This policy proposes the revision and revamping of all aspects of the education structure, including its regulation and governance, to create a new system that is aligned with the aspirational goal of 21st century education, including sustainable development goals, while building upon India's tradition and value system. The National Educational Policy lays emphasis on the development of creative potential of each individual. My dear friends, here I would like to highlight creative potential of each individual. In order to achieve this goal, there is need to have discussions and brainstorming sessions on the topic, such as reflection on holistic, multidisciplinary and futuristic aspects in higher education. In that way, the topic or the theme crafted for this virtual conference is very much designed in the line of need of the present scenario. At the same time, as you have reacted to this conference, and of course since morning you heard many speakers and which they have thrown light on the issues of higher education which are to be discussed in depth. When we talk about the education, we know that enabling the mind to find out the problems and its solution, that is the main theme or the main objective lying behind the entire education system. And as it is reflected in the National Education Policy 2020, transformation of India, in order to achieve this objective, we have to understand the entire process of education, how it takes place, and the different pathways to reach to the goals. You know, when or all of us are well acquainted with the situation since 2020 we are facing, and that is related to pandemic. In one of the news items in Times of India, it appears that there was a question raised by the writer: is hybrid learning the future of education? In line of that statement, we got to know that more than 1.2 billion children in 186 countries got affected by school closure due to pandemic. This forced educational institutions to adopt online technologies at breakneck speed. And see that technology having a social impact has evolved and matured based on the realization that it will require innovative methods for mass instruction. We are in India. We know the rural structure of India. Many of our families, they are deprived of this internet and ICT facility. So to address this issue with particular objective, we teacher or we faculty members in the domain of higher education should know what are the different multidisciplinary and futuristic aspects. In order to achieve and accomplish the objectives which are determined by our system, we have to acquaint with all these issues and solutions to it. When we see about the current dilemma, and as you know, as the world surges towards a new way of life, the question being asked is, what is educational model from now on? Is available model will serve the need, or is the present model will equip the society with the determined goal? Will the traditional education system resume? Will the online classes continue with half the children remaining non-responsive, or is there a choice that offers the best of both systems? These questions will storm the mind of the academicians, and what could happen? That is to be answered by having such kind of conferences. What would be the solution for this? There is one observation made by Naysers, he believes that the unplanned and rapid push for online learning with no training for teachers, insufficient bandwidth and connectivity issue will result in a poor user experience that is unconducive to sustained learning. This is very important to think over these observations, but many educators believe that a new hybrid model of education will emerge with significant benefits. It will be a tapestry meshing the benefit of work from home and co-working space. At the same time, or to address this particular issue, we need to have multidisciplinary approach. We cannot stop learning, or we cannot restrict our learners to learn only in particular domain or in particular discipline. Even though our education system is, or our education system should have multidisciplinary approach, because to cope up with the situation and to in order to achieve the goal, teacher has to be empowered, has to be well acquainted with different approaches which are highlighted in different disciplines. For example, I cannot say that I am confined to education discipline. Beyond that, I would learn, or I should learn, what are the different models to get good outcome from the learner, and that will definitely help me to achieve my objectives. Then the second thing which is very important, we have to see that ki how online learning can be more effective. Online sessions would be conducted with non-synchronous instruction that have to be followed, like a research trip to an area where a student can decide how and when to undergo the trip, deduce the parameter for research and carry out work accordingly. At the same time, learners can be called to classroom on a rotation basis for discussion, clarification of doubts, group assignment and assessment. For those who do have access to right technology, there is evidence that learning online can be more effective in number of ways. Even in addition to these observations, there are some researches which shows that on average student retain 25 to 60% more material when learning online compared to only 8 to 10% in a classroom. This is mostly due to the students being able to learn faster online. Students engaged in e-learning require 40 to 60% less time to absorb a concept than they do in a traditional classroom setting. Then, besides these observations, there is one observation which was made by Bhavani Shankar Nayak, who belongs to UK University, and he spoke very well ki this zooming or the online teaching will finish the growth of teacher. And he marked in his article titled as Zooming: The Death of Teaching and Teaching Profession. In that article, he highlighted the observation that this online teaching will stop the growth and relation between teacher and taught. Now, this is to be underlined. What kind of exactly we want, what kind of things we need to have, need to acquaint in our system. And then I think the hybrid education or a hybrid model of learning emerges. What is this hybrid model or hybrid model of education and training? Emphasis on what? Self-confidence, and prepares the trainees to be self-disciplined and self-dependent qualities that have real world application and aid better prospects for professional growth. These models of hybrid education, or n number of models are there, or with the hybrid model of learning, greater flexibility allows better teaching and hence effective learning we expect in the class. At the same time, what would be the future? And to face the challenges which are upcoming, looking to our future scenario, we should know, we should have the knowledge of such kind of things. Pedagogy focuses on different kinds of things because ultimately pedagogy is a science of teaching. So one should realize that what would be the future needs, and to acquaint, to fulfill, to face, to cope up with the situation, he or she should be able to develop her own model, considering ki there will be a need of hybrid education. My friends, I know that since morning many of the speakers must have focused the different aspects in higher education in general, and multidisciplinary and futuristic aspect in special. So I think there is no need to give much focus on these aspects. So at the last, I would say that the efforts taken by Satyam institutions and faculty members and all the heads, their efforts were so honest to reach to the ultimate goal of the conference, and I would extend congratulations to all of them. And in future, definitely we would have these kind of sessions under the banner of Satyam Group of Institutions. So thanks to all, and I would express my heartfelt congratulations to the head of the institutions. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Your presence in the conference was indeed a source of motivation for all of us. and you guided us through the event that by adopting a multidisciplinary approach in the education, it is quite become obvious to to teach in a good way. So it is really good. And also you told us that how not to confine yourself to the one discipline you belong to. Means you should belong to each and everything that you are in which you are, and which in whatever discipline you are, you should go into that. So this was really a source of motivation for all of us. We always look forward to your guidance and blessings. Dear friends, competing at higher level is not about winning. It's about better comprehension, evolution, and excellence. It is the result of always striving to do better with optimism. The perpetual optimism acts as a force pushing you towards your goal. So it is the time to announce the best research paper presentation award held in technical sessions too. And without much ado, I would like to invite Ms. Priyanka Sarkar, Program Head SJMC, to declare the result of the best research paper presentation of all the departments. Ma'am, please come.
Thank you so much, ma'am. A very good evening to all the respected dignitaries, esteemed participants, and my dear students. First of all, my heartiest congratulations and greetings for organizing this international conference, virtual international conference on reflection of holistic, multidisciplinary, and futuristic aspects in higher education. The research paper presentations were held in all the three departments of Satyam Group of Institution Noida, namely Satyam Fashion Institute, Satyam College of Education, and School of Journalism and Mass Communication. The themes of the research paper of Satyam Fashion Institute were transformation in vocational skills through design, challenges and opportunity, and sustainability in design practices. The second theme were sustainability in design practices. The themes for Satyam College of Education were hybrid education, challenges and opportunity, and life skill education in context of National Education Policy 2020. The themes of research paper for School of Journalism and Mass Communication were Future Direction of Media Education in India and Making Indian Media Education Holistic and Multidisciplinary. The best paper award are being presented to authors whose work represent groundbreaking research work in their respective areas. The best paper have been selected by recognizing their originality and importance, which highlighted some of the theoretical and practical innovation that are likely to shape the future of the respective areas of study. The committee has recognized the following best three papers in the field of design, media, and education. We are pleased to announce the winners for the best paper award. We wish to congratulate all the paper presenters for presenting their genuine research work. Now, it's our pleasure to announce that the Best Paper Award for Fashion Design goes to Dr. Nidhi Gupta, Department of Fabric and Apparel, Lady Irwin College, University of Delhi, and co-author was Dr. Seema Shekri. Dr. Seema Shekri, she was from Department of Fabric and Apparel Science, Lady Irwin College, University of Delhi, and the title of the presentation was Sustainable Care Practice Through Garment Design. Congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
And we are happy to announce that the Best Paper Award of Education goes to Ms. Harshita Panjani, PhD Scholar, Amity School of Education, AUUP Delhi, AUUP Noida. And the topic of the presentation was Hybrid Education, Challenges and Opportunity. Congratulations. And from School of Journalism and Mass Communication, the Best Paper Award goes to Dr. Moina Khan, Associate Professor, Bennett University. And the title of the presentation was An Interdisciplinary Thought of Media Education in India.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And give me this opportunity to thank the panel and thank the professor and dean at Satyam Institute. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you and congratulations. It was indeed a pleasure to hear you. The three papers are sound work that covers cutting edge topics in three different areas, and they are characterized by high novelty and relevance to both scientific audience and industry practitioners. We would like to congratulate all the winners. Thank you so much once again. Have a nice evening. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. And thank you, Satyam Group of Institutions, for providing this us this platform and this opportunity.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Congratulations to the winners and the participants for achieving yet another milestone in their academic life. I wish you all a great success in your own upcoming future endeavors. The reward of thing well done is having done it. However, we would be falling short of our duty if we do not recognize the thing well done and encourage it. May I now request Dr. Neetu Malhotra, HOD SFI, for the vote of thanks. Ma'am, please come.
Thank you so much, Vanna Verma. Good evening, all. It has been our pleasure to host all the participants of the International Virtual Conference and Satyam Group of Institutions, Noida. We have been fortunate to have some of the eminent persons from academia and the industry to join us on this special day. I feel honored and privileged to have the opportunity to propose a vote of thanks on this special evening. This is the proudest day in the history of our institute. Today, we have hosted our international conference with 400 delegates across the streams of education, design, and media. On behalf of the group of institutions, I convey my regards and hearty thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Ujula Chakradeva, and Professor Dr. Shashikala Vanjari, and guest of honor, Professor Sarosh Sharma, for kindly accepting our invitation and gracing the conference with their presence. I'm thankful to the honorable session chairs for the enthusiastic participation in this conference. Dr. Anupma Pasricha, Dr. Praveen Chauhan, Professor Arti Srivastava, Professor Dr. Rita Sonawat, Professor Devesh Kishore, Professor Dr. Alia Ahmed. I thank our esteemed delegates, our expert speakers, Ms. Sonia Jaitley, Ms. Sonil Jain, Ms. Anju Tulshian, Dr. Nidhi Goyal, Dr. Jonali Barua, Dr. Upma Chaturvedi, Professor Sanjeev Bhanawat, Professor Subhash Dhulia, Dr. Ved Tiwari for enlightening us with their thoughts and ideas. Words are not enough to tell you how this conference is going to help in forming vocational education, sustainable and national education policy, related strategies, and I'm sure that all the participants have benefited by listening to these brilliant minds at this conference. I would also like to acknowledge our chairperson, the secretary, the entire management, principals, HODs, and the organizing team, teachers, staff, and technical team members for their unwavering support. I should not forget to thank the volunteers, the student teams who put their best efforts into arranging this conference. Thank you very much again. In the end, I would like to thank all the respected delegates and the participants, the college authorities. Thank you again for making this event successful. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Once again, I congratulate and express my sincere gratitude to each and everyone in all civility for making the event a great success. We have now reached the end of the valedictory function. There is an end to everything, but we believe there is never an end but always a beginning. Before closing, now it's time for the national anthem. I request everyone to kindly follow the protocol and stand properly in your respective positions.